This paper is insanity. Why? Well, today you are going to see a revolution in virtual worlds. You see, we can create a virtual copy of a real-world scene around us by using NeRFs. What are those? Well, those are an absolutely magical technique where we take photos of a real scene, but don't record the whole thing. There are holes between the images, and a NeRF will be able to synthesize what is there in these holes. Absolute magic. This already works really well. Look, this is a scene. And just imagine the possibilities having a meeting or playing a video game in a real city around us. Or even training self-driving cars in a simulation to make sure they are safe before they come out into the real world. How cool would that be? However, not so fast. If we start growing this scene, we run out of resources on our hardware, and unfortunately, this puts a limit on how big we can think. So, scenes are okay, but cities, not so much. But scientists at NVIDIA say that they have a solution. What? Really? Well, let's have a look together. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai-Fehér. Yes, you heard it right. They say that they can now create virtual scenes that are so much bigger than previous ones. Let's see if they delivered. So, how much bigger? Level 1. This is not just a scene, but a whole racetrack. I'm liking this one, especially that this is 1 square kilometer or almost 0.4 square miles in size. Potential progress in self-driving cars and racing games on real tracks. So cool. Now, let's think even bigger. Level 2. Ooh, this is so much bigger. A beach 6 square kilometers, almost 2.5 square miles. 6 times the size of the first racetrack. Now this is incredible. The details are not super crisp, but for a game where we fly over this beach or for a simulation of what could happen if it got flooded, chef's kiss. And now, scholars, let's think even bigger. The final boss, level 3. An entire city. This is 25 times as big as the first example. Wow! Now we're talking. We are going to have a look at that in a moment, but wait a minute. All this should be impossible. We said that as we grow the scene, we run out of resources on the graphics card. So, how? How does all this magic happen? Well, the key here is that scientists were able to dissect this huge problem into many smaller problems and distribute these smaller chunks among several graphics cards. Each of them are like little ants grabbing a little crumb. This way, we have more memory in total. However, as the data is distributed, these graphics cards have to communicate with each other. That is not easy. So, each takes care of their part, and then they can communicate and put together the complete solution super quickly. This is what we call a distributed algorithm, and creating something for this problem is a huge feat. But wait, I hear you asking, Károly, are you saying that this can have 250,000 images stitched together and the blanks filled in so we can get a virtual world? Well, let's see that whole city. Now, hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, and observe. Ooh, holy mother of papers! That is just unbelievable! An almost 10 square mile city digitized from a collection of photos, and now we can play in it. So good! And just think about it. This was the original NeRF paper from 4 years ago. It could do a scene. That's it. And now, a couple papers down the line, and 4 years later, we get an entire city. Loving it. But note a few drawbacks. The quality of the fine details is not the greatest, So, you would probably need a super resolution technique of sorts to guess what those details could be. Also, this is not cheap, as it requires quite a few graphics cards, up to 64 are required for the city. But let's invoke the first law of papers and imagine what we will be capable of two more papers down the line. Perhaps first it will run on just one graphics card in your desktop machine or laptop, and then maybe even on your phone in your pocket. Stranger things have happened in research before. What a time to be alive! I will also note that most of this technique is handcrafted, so all this is possible mostly because of human ingenuity. Loving it! If you're looking for an NVIDIA GPU cloud service for large-scale AI projects, check out One-Click Clusters by Lambda, featuring up to 512 NVIDIA H100 GPUs with InfiniBand networking. And hold on to your papers, because with One-Click Clusters, you can access all these GPUs on demand with reservations starting at just 2 weeks. Try it out at lambdalabs.com/paper or click the link in the description.